Hello children, welcome to 8th social class. In the previous class, children, we started the topic, the earth, our living planet. Regarding the topic, I completed the topic, the different name of the earth, such as the earth is known as the living planet, unique planet, waterly planet and blue planet because of the nature or the qualities which we can see on the earth. It may be a living gas or the atmosphere or the water availability or the living atmosphere which is suitable for the existence of a human being. Depending upon that, we have different name had been given to earth. Clear children? Then the size of the earth, what is the size of earth? The size of earth, which is 4 times greater than the moon. Why? Comparing to sun. And the earth is 107 times less in its diameter. It means that it is 4 times greater than the moon and 107 times smaller than the sun. That was the size of the earth. And what is the total surface area of the earth? The total surface area of the earth is 510 million square kilometer. That was the total surface of the earth. Then 361 million square kilometer of a water, whereas 149 million square kilometer of a land available on the earth. So the ratio between land and water is 1:2.43. That is the ratio of a water as well as a land on the earth. See, depending upon that, we call it or we name it as a land and the water masses. The land masses are called as a continent. I told there are 7 continents like North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia and Australia. This is a 7 land masses. The land mass is known as a continent. In that, biggest or the largest one is Asia, whereas the smallest one is the Australia. And waterly bodies are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean and Arctic Ocean. Clear children? In that, largest is a Pacific Ocean, whereas shallowest one is a Arctic Ocean. That is a waterly body of a earth. And I also told about the shape of a earth. The shape of the earth is geoid, means the earth shape is oblate or a sphere. Because why it is? Because it is flattened at the pole and bulged at the equator, and it is proven as the polar diameter and the polar circumference is lesser than the equatorial diameter and equatorial circumference. Why it is the shape is geoid or oblate? Because the polar diameter and the polar circumference is lesser than the equatorial diameter and equatorial circumference. Clear children? And the difference of a 42 kilometer in diameter is the proof for the regarding the geoid shape of the earth. That I hope you remember that in the last class I drawn small shape of the earth. In that difference I wrote, and that 42 kilometer also I shown in my diagram which I have done in the last class. Clear children? Then the land bodies of the earth are called as a continent, and the large water bodies are called as a ocean. Then the land hemisphere and water hemisphere. What is the land hemisphere and the water hemisphere? See, this is a northern place of a earth which was consists of a 60% of a land and 40% of a water. So it is called as a land hemisphere, whereas southern hemisphere is called as a waterly hemisphere because of the opposite in the sense 19% of a land and 81% of a water. Here 81% of a water and 19% of a land, so that it can be called as a water hemisphere, southern hemisphere, which is called as a water hemisphere, and also that this line is called as a latitude. Remember that this horizontal line is called as a latitude. Latitude divide the earth. Latitude divide the earth as a northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Clear? Whereas this middle vertical line, can you see children? This vertical line is called as a longitude. So this vertical line divide the earth as western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. And here you can see the shape of the earth, which is we will call it as a geosphere oblate space. This is the pole and this middle one called as a equator. So you can see here by it or the flat earth, where this is the pole side. You can see the shape here in the pole. Is it clear, children? So this is the northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere, western hemisphere, whereas this is the eastern hemisphere. So the next one is line of latitude and line of a longitude. So what is the line of a latitude here? You can see this thin line. This is all imaginary line which was drawn on the earth. And this is the parallel line. You can see here, children, that this is the parallel line. You can see it. And this horizontal line is called as a line of latitude. The line, horizontal line, which is parallel. Parallel means, you know, which goes straight, which never intersect each other. So this is called as a line of a latitude. And middle one, the largest line of the latitude, was called as a equator. Clear, children? See, this is a line of a latitude. Line of a latitude, and which is a parallel, which never intersect each other, and the largest latitude was known as a equator, which was in the middle. Can you see here red line, children? This is the line of a equator. Clear? And this is the line of a longitude. So this is a vertical line. You can see here. See, the difference is that what you can see in the sense here, that the line to line which is there in the latitude, which of no equal distance. Clear, children? See, from here to here there is no equal distance. Here you can see smaller one, then little bit large, compared to like this, when this middle line, that was the equator, is the largest one, because this is the largest, because the circumference of the earth, which is equal to equator. What is that? The circumference of the earth, which is equal to this equator line. Whereas here in the longitude, you can see this also imaginary line, and this is the middle line of the longitude, which is called as a prime meridian. Clear? And here you can see the equal distance between each line of a longitude. Here there is no equal distance, whereas in the line of a longitude you can see the equal distance between the each place. So that is the latitude and longitude. Now exactly what is latitude? What are the features of a latitude? See, latitude is an imaginary line which join all the places at the same angular distance from north or south of the equator. So what is a latitude? It is a imaginary line which join all the places at the same angular distance north or south of the equator. So see, this is a what the shape of a latitude, which is an imaginary line which join the same places which having a same angular distances, which it should have a same distance here, and this is a north and south, which have a same angular distance. that is joy. So what is that? See, latitude is an imaginary line which joins all the places at the same angular distance, north or a south of a equator. Then it is measured in degree. It was measured in a degree, and the equator is the longest line of the latitude, known as a great circle. I told that equator, the red line which was in the middle, that was known as a great circle, which is of a 0 degree, and it is equal to the circumference of the earth. I have shown it was equal to the circumference of the earth. And other line of the latitude are shorter length. Shorter in the sense, you may remember the shape, which is a shorter line when compared to the middle line. Clear, children? Then, which are the famous few of the latitude or the fact about the latitude? Which are they? See, they are known as the parallel. I told. See, these are the parallel lines. Then, run in east-west direction. Which run in a east-west direction? The see the line which was drawn. Then measure distance north or south from the equator. What does it do? Measure the distance from north or south. From north to south, it measures the distance from the equator or the great circle. Then these are parallel to one another, which never meet. I told previously that it is a parallel line. You can see on moving, but it will never intersect each other. Then cross the prime meridian at the right angle. This cross the prime meridian. Prime meridian in the sense, you remember, you have remember I showed in a longitude line, the line which comes like this, longitude vertical line, in that one middle red line has been came. Remember that is here comes 0 line 0 degree. Here the prime meridian will come vertically. So cross the prime meridian right angles and lies in place, but cross the earth axis at the right angle. This line also cross the earth axis. You know the axis of earth which cut the earth in a right angle. Then get shorter towards the pole only with the equator. The longest is a great in the sense, which is a short in a pole, and you can see wide longitude latitude only in the equator. It means that it becomes shorter and shorter in the pole, and you can see only wide latitude only in the equator in the sense middle of the earth, because of the circumference of the earth and equatorial circumference equal, so that only the middle of the equator is a wide, remaining all is a shorter one when compared to this. This is the feature of a latitude. I repeat once again, these are parallel, run in east-west direction, measure the distance north or south from the equator, and these are the parallel to one and other which never meet, and cross the prime meridian at the right angle, and lines planes that cross the earth axis at the right angle. In the sense, these lines meet the earth in a axis, earth on its axis only on the right angle, and it gets shorter towards the pole, which is shorter in the pole, and wide only on equator side. Then which are the famous or the important latitude? Which are the important latitudes? See, this you will get to draw on your map for a 1 mark question. You will get on this. See, any latitude they may ask you to draw. So this particular point is the north pole, which is a 90 degree in a north. These are measured in a degree. Remember, children, these are measured in degree, 90 degree in a north. And this circle is called as a Arctic circle, which is 66.4 0.5 degree in north, and this is the important, okay, this is Tropic of Cancer, which is 23.5 degree in north, and this is the equator, which is a 0 degree, and this line is Tropic of Cancer, which is 23.5 degree in south, and this one, here you line, can you see, this line is the Antarctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree in south, and again this is the South Pole, which is a 90 degree south. See children, what you have observed here, the equator divided both north and south in a equal degree. What does it did? It divided the earth. It divided the earth on same degree, both in the north as well as the south. See here also 66.5, 23.5, 0. After this here again you can see 23.5, 66.5. Only the north and south difference you can see. In the sense, the earth which was like this on the north, when you make it opposite, then it will come first. 23 comes first, then 66.5 comes last. That was the because of the shape of the earth. This is the important latitudes. Then move on to longitudes. What is the longitude? These are imaginary lines that intersect equator at right angles, join the north and south, are called as a longitude. What is that? Which is a imaginary line that intersect the equator. Equator, which is the equator, that middle line of the earth, horizontal middle line, which intersect the equator at the right angle, at the right angle, joining the north and south. It means that, see, this is a longitude, isn't it? Imagine that this is the line of our equator comes. Clear? And here you may take, say exactly like here. Here the line of the equator comes, and which join longitude, which join north and south pole, and which meet the equator in a 0 degree, that too in the right angle. This is the right side. Here, right side which meet in a 0 degree, which means north pole as well as the south pole. Clear? Clear now children, what is it? These are the imaginary line which meet north and south pole. Also it meets the equator in the right angle. It means this is the right angle. Here it meets the what? Equator. So what are the facts? So these are known as a meridian. Longitude also known as a meridian. Why it is known as a meridian? Meridian means, meridian refer to midday. Or a midday. Why it is line or called as a longitude? Because see, the lines of longitude are called as a meridian because it is a midday. Midday in the sense, all places along the same meridian of longitude experience noon or midday at the same time. Example, see, these are the what? Line of a longitude. And assume that a place comes on this line. This is A, B, C, D. From here, A to the Z places, imagine Z places comes, and these all the from A to Z line at the same time experience noon. Noon in the sense 12 o'clock. The same time they all feel 12 o'clock because you know that the times are different. We are now in the time of a thing that now we are in a 10 o'clock. They may have a 12 o'clock or a 4 o'clock or the 3 o'clock. Because of these difference, the times are different because of the rotation of the earth, that we will see in the next topic. But here the places which comes in the same line of a longitude experience same time in the sense it may be a 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock means from here to here, whichever place comes, they all experience same time. It is a 12 o'clock because of midday, noon. It was known as the meridians. then run in a north south direction. Have you observed it runs in a north south direction? Then measure distance east or west of a prime meridian. It means that it will measure the distance from west to east, east to west, the same distance which was measured. Then are farthest apart the equator and meet at the pole. It means that it means from it start from the north pole which meet the equator here, again it will meet the pole at the end. What does it mean? Are farthest apart the equator and meet the pole means the journey of the longitude start from the north pole which meet the equator here, again the journey of the longitude continue and end with the south pole, and these lies in a place that pass through the earth axis. Like a longitude, it also meet the earth on its axis. How it may meet on the axis, in the sense, see, this is an imaginary line which was drawn on the earth, right? Now example you take, this side is the axis of earth, oval shape axis. When it rotate, these all the line which intersect the earth axis. Clear children? You may know the what? The shape of the earth, how it will rotate on the earth. Imagine that rotation of the earth axis. When the earth take a rotation, all this line which meet the sun axis, earth axis. Clear? All this line interact or which intersect the earth axis in a right angle. Then are equal in length. You remember that latitude which are not in a equal length, whereas these are equal length. See, here, from here, the same distance you can observe from the beginning to end. Whereas latitude, it comes like this. Here small, then little bit wide, then little bit wide, then the only equator is the largest equatorial you can find. But here, all line of a longitude is the same, even the prime meridian also. Clear? Whereas latitude, only the equator is the largest one, but here longitude is all of a same length. These are Havels of the Great Circle. Havels in the sense, see, children, you can see only here half circle. Half circle you can see, isn't it? See, from these lines, each line you see, it will show you as only a half circle. Where about the remaining half circle is on the next side of the earth, isn't it? So it looked like a semicircle. So it was called as a Havels. Havels in the sense, remaining half circle is on other side of the earth. Clear children? Then see. Now here you can see the shape of the longitude. See, these are series of semicircles that run from pole to pole passing through the equator. These are the semicircle line children, which run from pole to pole, from north pole to south pole, which meet the equator. In the sense, middle one equator line was drawn, that can be seen there. Then all line of longitude are equal length. I told you that each line of a longitude which was in a equal length and longitude are also called as a meridian. I told why it is called as a meridian, because all the places on the same meridian which experience same time or the noon, it will feel. So it was called as a meridian. Because of all the places along the same meridian of the longitude experience the noon or midday at the same time. Clear children? This is a latitude and longitude. Then see, here you may ask that how the longitude divide in the sense, I told you it looked like a semicircle, and half of the side or one side you can see remaining one side which was hidden on the other side of the earth. So when it was split, when it was expanded like this diagram, you can see west side, east side, where this diagram, remember carefully, because this calculation was important for the calculation of a time. When you are referring a time zone, this is important. See how this is entire globe which was divided as a west as well as the east. Here both the side in the sense west side 180 degree, east side 180 degree, again 150 in the west, another 150 in the east, 120 120. What is this in the sense? This is a line of a longitude. I have told drawn in the sense you are seeing only one side of the angle. Look at here, see. Can you see here again? 150, 150 east, 180 degree in the west, 180 degree in the south. The same which we are expanded like this. See, when it was expanded, both the west side as well as the east side, which has a equal zone measure. See, 150 west, 120 east. So from north to south, the distance or the degree which was divided equal. So totally 180 plus 180 has become 360. Remember that 360 degree, where total longitude was 360. Here how it was divided, and the Greenwich England. Can you see here? Greenwich is a prime meridian, the mean on the earth. On the earth, this point was considered as a prime meridian, and which comes in a Greenwich place of a England. It means that, see, out of this, assume it as a prime meridian, and middle one, the place was comes as a England, Greenwich place. That can be located here. See, Greenwich, England. This is a known as a prime meridian place. Then, what is the link between longitude and time? See, the earth is rotating on its axis and completed one rotation in a 24 hours. Is it clear, children? So, earth will rotate on its axis. To complete its one rotation, it will take 24 hours. 24 hours in the sense, one day. Clear? Then, this means 360 of longitudes are covered in a period of 24 hours. Now is it clear how it comes? 360 in the sense, here, see, both west and east, the rotation of the earth takes place, then the entire 360 degree which will be covered. Means in a one day, 360 degree the earth will rotate, it means 1 hour. And suppose 360 divided by 24 hours, it comes in a 15 degree. It comes in a 15 degree. The earth rotate in 50 degree each hour. Out of 24 hours, children, let's go slowly. Out of 24 hours, one hour, the earth will take 15 degree of a rotation it will take. Clear? Rotation you get globe. If you have a globe, just take a globe and do practically that. Suppose if you want to rotate the earth, slowly the movement of earth, you can observe that movement 15 degree it will take in a 1 hour because of the calculation. 360 divided by 24, which comes 15 degree, it means earth rotate in 15 degree in a each hour. So 60 minutes divided by 15 degree comes as a 4 minutes. So it rotate 1 degree in a 4 minutes. So for a 4 minute, the rotation of the earth is only 1 degree. So, in a 4 minute, the earth will rotate in a only 1 degree. So, is this calculation clear? See, I'll read out. The earth is rotating on its axis and complete its rotation in 24 hours. It means 360 longitude are covered in a period of a 24 hours. That means 1 day. If we divide 360 degree divided by 24 hours, it comes as a 15 degree. Earth rotates in 15 degree each hour, and 60 minutes divided by 15 degree, which means 40 minutes, Earth rotates 1 degree in a 40 minutes. So children, this is about longitude and time. Little bit 3 or 4 topic is there that I will continue in the next class. Till then children, see you.